What's going on, guys? ASMR Boosters here, as always, trying out something new. I figured out how to record on PS4, finally. And, this is my second go so far. The first one, the audio in the game was much too loud. You could barely hear what I was saying at all. Which is unfortunate, because I had an amazing first run. I picked Isaac, which you can only do at the start of the game. You have no other characters unlocked. And I made it all the way to the end in like 15 minutes. It was great. Yeah, but I had to delete it because the in-game audio was far too loud. So I turned it off, and hopefully that works. So for those of you who have never played this game, it's called The Binding of Isaac. Basically, the story goes, your mother gets a message from God to kill her son Isaac, who is you. Your goal is to make it all the way through the basement and escape her or kill her. And that's what we're going to do. You have a tutorial here. Left, right, up, down is to move your right analog stick, or the shape buttons are to shoot your tears. There's a map which you can like move all over. Yeah, you can only see the rooms you've been to unless you use an item to unlock a map or whatever, or get a map. There's your health right there. Right there you have coins, bombs, and keys. Up in the corner there you can get a spacebar item which you use L2 to use. Down here you'll get a trinket which has special abilities depending on what you get. There's like 200, I don't know. Down here you can get pills or cards which also have use effects. You fight all sorts of different weird creatures. They're almost all like baby, body, and bug related. This is an item room with the gold door. The first room, they're always free. This is a health up, so now I have 4 heart containers, as you can see there. That's a troll bomb. There are poops and fires throughout the rooms. So these are trinkets. This one, I think it just pulls your... You can get like minions that follow you. I think it pulls them closer to you. But this item makes it so you get more coins and stuff when you shoot poops. It's amazing. It's very good. You can go through all the floors, all the rooms, and fight everything if you want. But for the sake of not making this an hour-long video and having it mess up, we're gonna fight the boss. I always try to kill the little mobs first on a boss that doesn't spawn them on its own. So Monstro, number one, doesn't usually spawn his own mobs. So I kill them. So now it's just me and this... He's got cleft tooth, cleft lip or whatever it's called. I don't know the actual term for it. I don't want to like accidentally offend someone or something with ignorance, because I don't know. But his name's Monstro, anyways. And he's a very easy boss once you learn his patterns. He jumps around, he'll jump in the air and land, and he'll shoot. This is another health upgrade. Oh no, it's speed and size, okay. And speed down, which doesn't matter because the speed up pill, I think, does more than the speed downgrade. I think that's how it works. Or the speed up item does more than the pill downgrades it. Something like that. I haven't, like, religiously played this game in years. I play it when I just need to kill some time, usually. That's battery. When you get a use item up there, had so much money. Spider webs on the ground, as you can guess, they slow you down. You get stuck to them. So now, the item room for this floor needs a key. I don't have a key. So we have to try and get one. I have one bomb. There are secret rooms, throughout the floor. Where they are. I don't think there's a 100% guarantee always, but there are easier ways of guesstimating where they are. And we got a key. It's fantastic. So I always prioritize the item room. Always. Unless we're overpowered and I need to get into a shop for something. So speed and range up. Now I'm just cruising around the floor. Next key I get, I'll either, if I only get one, I will save it. Oh my god, moving is hard now. I will either save it for the next floor, or I'll use it to get into the shop. The shop, you trade coins, obviously, for consumables or items. There are only a couple items that I will actually buy from the shop. One of those being, there's coin there, but the secret room might be here. I'm gonna try for the secret room, and it is. So, the reason I could tell that that was the secret room was because there was three joining walls. There's minimum two. And I think it's usually the one closest to the shop. I'm not sure how that works anymore. So, any of the corners of this room, so that one room there, that room, that would be like up here, this one, or on the other side, could have been a shop, or could have been a secret room, but it was this one, and I guessed it because there was three walls joining, and one of those was a shop. So now, what I can do is I can bomb into the shop instead of using a key, and I'm assuming you only get three items until you beat the game a couple times. I've never really had that problem. I'm not sure. So what I just got was a spirit heart. It will protect my red hearts. But once it's gone, it's gone. There's no getting a spirit heart back. You can get more spirit hearts, obviously. But, like, they don't refill. Whereas, like, red hearts, you can find pieces of them throughout the stage and they'll fill up the container. There's no container. So, if you have soul hearts or spirit hearts or whatever you call them, you can... Oh my gosh, I'm doing badly. I always suck at these poop fights. If you take no red heart damage on the floor, and with the boss, you get a deal with the devil chance. It's a room that will open after you fight a boss. That gives you a chance to get better items in exchange for your health containers. Now, there are things to influence it. Oh gosh. Like if you, there's little beggars throughout the floors sometimes. You can give them keys, money, or hearts. Not heart containers, just like refills, I guess. And if you blow those guys up, they influence your chance of getting a deal with the devil. Now, if you don't take a deal with the devil, you have a chance of getting an angel room, which gives you an item for free. Every time you beat a boss, you get an item. So you saw that we unlocked something because that was the first time I beat the I started a new file for this. So if you guys want me to keep playing, let me know. This is called a curse room. You can go in and out of it. And sometimes it'll have items, sometimes it'll have enemies. Sometimes it'll have almost nothing. But it costs you a heart, half a heart to get in, half a heart to get out. They've updated the game so much throughout the years, I can never remember if that red heart damage counts towards your devil chance or not. A deal with the devil room also has a chance of spawning out enemies. Who early game is a real pain in the butt because he shoots lasers like fire beams that go all the way across the room and they hurt. He also flies and shoots stuff at you like bullets or tears, I guess. Every floor is randomly generated. Beside it. And I can push L2 to use it and I get a pill. I can use the pill on the bottom right using R1 and it'll have an effect. Pills are a huge chance because they can either be really good or they can be really bad or they can do pretty much nothing. There's a pill called puberty that just makes you grow a couple of hairs on your head. This boss is called Little Chub, I believe, or Chub, or something. It's just a giant maggot or tapeworm. Some sick thing. Now, when he does that open mouth attack, you can drop a bomb in front of him. He will eat it and then do bomb damage. But I have no bombs, and unless you get a large amount of bombs, it's easier to just sit here and bait his attacks so that he charges at you and you can shoot at him. It takes a while. Some of these bosses are like, they take so long in the beginning of the game because you have no damage. These little things, they just take one or two hits at the most, like, preferably you just kill them instantly, because they suck, they're no fun to fight. The ones that charge at you are the scariest. Okay. That white one is called an eternal heart. So we gotta deal with the devil, and we got a damage health upgrade right here. Or speed and damage, I guess, and I always get them mixed up. The Eternal Heart will make my red heart turn partially white. When I go down to the next floor, it will turn into a full container. Now, if I go into this room and Krampus is in there, you can kiss that Eternal Heart goodbye, because I never don't take damage on him. So, I got lucky. He gave me two black hearts, which make it so they're spirit hearts, essentially, but when I lose one, they damage an entire room of enemies. This thing is called a Whore of Babylon. Whore. It makes it so if I only have half a heart, half a red heart left, I get a huge damage upgrade. I turn into, like, this black demon. And it sucks because I don't like having one much. If you don't get Mom's Knife or Brimstone, which, if anyone's ever watched any Binding of Isaac playthroughs or anything, those are like the best items to get in the game because they're so good. They do piercing damage and lots of it, and they're just awesome. But unless you get those items or something equally as good, sometimes it's best to just go for angel rooms. You can already see enemies are taking me a little while to kill. So I'm gonna need a damage upgrade at some point of some sort. Throughout the floor. That's the best thing you could do. And I do have the petrified poop, so I will pop all these poops. Let me know in the comments below how this video turned out. If I need, like, obviously a better microphone will always help, but at the moment, just trying to, I have to spend a whole bunch of money on my dog. I have to take her to the vet here in the next couple weeks. She has hip dysplasia, which, if anybody knows what that is, it sucks for a one-year-old dog to have it. So, Pinky Shears is an amazing item. I'll use this first to get the pill. The pill dropped a spider friend. The Pinky Shears, what it does is it cuts my head off and lets my head fly and my body run around freely. My body will do damage to the enemies while my head can go hide. I won't use it unless I need it or on the boss, because it makes bosses like a cakewalk. Those enemies that blow up and shoot tears everywhere, they're kind of a wild guy. I hate these things because they have amazing aim. As soon as you get in a horizontal or vertical line with them, they will launch these bones at you. So you kind of have to hit them from an angle. When Especially when you have no damage. Because they have lots of health. But basically, you run in front of them and get them to shoot in a direction. And then you go around them. Okay, I might use the shears here. Guys can hit you very easily. Flight is one of the best thing. It is the best thing you can get. Besides lots of damage or tears up. So how this game works is anything that would make you cry is good. There's a trinket called Cancer, which gives you like a ton of tears. Cancer is sad. And that's how this game works, in a really messed up way. So I just got 48 hour energy, which makes it so I can cut my head off multiple times. So now I've got 3 bodies. And they're all running around, killing. So I got health. And with the devil rooms and angel rooms, once you get one, so you need to try and get it multiple times.
Isaac was cornered. His mother.
That's it for this video. There will be a little bit less.